Our friend, the senior senator from Minnesota, said about this confirmation process, she said, this is not normal. Well, I agree with her. Because if this is the new normal, woe be to the Senate and any nominee that would be subjected to the unacceptable character assassination that we've seen directed at this nominee in this case. If that's the new normal, I don't know who would want to serve, and frankly, I think people would be justified in losing any respect for the Senate and the way it conducts itself during the confirmation process. So more is at stake than just this nomination and the Supreme Court. The Senate itself is on trial here. A vote against Judge Kavanaugh tomorrow will be an endorsement of the mishandling of this confirmation process because of hiding relevant information that could have been examined on a bipartisan basis in a way that respected Dr. Ford's request for privacy and gotten to the bottom of this, as we have attempted to do now with 20 million people watching on television. A vote against Judge Kavanaugh tomorrow will be a vote for abusing the confirmation process and a good person, and it will be a vote for the shameful intimidation tactics that have been employed as part of an orchestrated smear campaign. I agree that the FBI investigation, now they've talked to a total of 150 different people through the 7 background investigations that Judge Kavanaugh has been through since 1993. No corroboration, no confirmation of any of these outrageous accusations that have been made against him. Unfortunately, this could have all been avoided. Most of the embarrassment to Dr. Ford and the public circus-like atmosphere, if the ranking member had just made the allegations known in the regular process and could have been investigated, as I said, in a way that would have protected her and her confidentiality. I've said before, and I say it again, I believe that we should, and we did, treat Dr. Ford the same way I would want my daughters or my wife or my mother treated under similar circumstances. But we have to remember that Judge Kavanaugh is entitled to a fair process, too, and he has not been subjected to a fair process, anything but. So now's the time to quit all of these antics, these hijinks, this circus-like atmosphere, and we'll do that tomorrow morning when we vote, and Saturday when we vote to finally confirm this good man to this important position.